Afghans are thronging to Kabul's airport, desperate to get on planes and leave the country at any cost. They're scaling the airport's walls this morning, rushing in. There's no screening, no security checks, just force of numbers.
अस्सलाम वालेकुम मदीना, क्या ले आप? ठीक ठाक हैं? रहमान शाह का बहन आप हैं? आप तो कुछ बोलना चाहते थे, मैं कैसे बोलूं? बोल भी नहीं सकता, बोलने की बात भी नहीं है, लेकिन ज़रा कोशिश करता हूँ कि बोलूं। वो आपके जो भाई था अफगानिस्तान के वार में तालिबान के साथ वार किया था, उसी में शहीद हो गया। कल मेरा दूसरे आर्मी उसे यहाँ लेके आएगा, उसका मैयत।
चाहती हो तू बेटी, हमारे मन में कोई हो तो बताओ, हम लोग को छुपाना मत। क्या बोला तुमने? वैसे बोलने की हिम्मत कैसे की तुमने? मैंने तुम्हारे लिए क्या नहीं किया?
Wait, you love her as a friend, right?
No, we want to get married.
What?
ऐसा नहीं हो सकता, हमारे परिवार में अभी तक ऐसा हुआ ही नहीं।
Are you insane, Rutika? Is this a joke?
No, mom. We love
each other. Nonsense.
हम लोग ये नहीं चाहते। ये क्या बोल रहे हैं तुम? इसे जरूरत कैसे क्या तुमने?
None of this in this house. Either you leave her,
or leave
this house.
No,
Krishna.
No,
I'm not. Walk there, walk there.
No, live without both of them. I can't live without her, and I can't live them also.
Suicide is a serious potential consequence of a mental illness. However, it is sad to see that almost everywhere in the world, mental illness is a taboo. Affected people are said to be victims of witchcraft, possessed by evil spirits and threatened to be inflicted with physical injury to get them back on track.
Hi, I am Urja Kankade and I am discussing about the various reasons that lead to suicide and the suicide ratio. So basically, the society blames the victim for their condition. People who often display these conditions are met with lots of hatred, contempt, fear and disclosure. These people are also sent to the spiritual healers for healing. Mental therapy and science-based psychiatric methods are practiced much less in most parts of the world, thus raising awareness and introducing these methods to the people who are suffering should be given the prime importance.
Some of the major factors contributing to suicide in 2019 were family problems, illness, drugs and alcohol abuse, marriage and love affairs, bankruptcy, failure in examination, unemployment, career problems, poverty disputes, death of a dear person, poverty, impotency, etc. Family problems push young people the most to commit suicide. They are the number one cause of suicide for Indians between the age group of 18 to 45 years. Let's have a look at the suicide ratio. Almost 8 lakh people die annually all around the world due to suicide. 1,39,123 Indians died due to suicide in 2019. National suicide rate was 10.4 per lakh of population. World Health Organization has stated that suicide is an emerging and serious public health issue. The suicide rates in India have only been ever rising over the last 5 decades.
Government has classified suicide as an unnatural death with the intent to die, originating from victim to end his life and had a reason to end his life which may be specified in a suicide note. Suicide is illegal and the survivor would face imprisonment of 1 year and fine under section 307 of IPC. Which is repealed in 2014. 90% of the people who have committed suicide have a diagnosable psychiatric disorder at the time. It can be treated through early detection, diagnosis, treatment of depression and other mental conditions. Depression is the most treatable psychiatric illness. Around 80 to 90% of the people have responded positively towards their treatment. but at first it has to be recognized.
Hi guys, I'm Kiara and I will be talking you through the various myths associated with suicide, how to deal with a person going through suicidal phase in their lives, and also the various warning signs.
It is dangerous to ask a depressed person whether they are contemplating suicide. You may be afraid of raising the subject of suicide with a vulnerable person for fear that even mentioning it could inspire them to harm themselves. But the reality is that those struggling with depression may be relieved to have the opportunity of sharing their disturbing thoughts, including the ones about suicide, with someone else, since it gives them the chance to think out loud and to process what they are going through. People who want to die always find a way to do so. This is not necessarily true. In fact, it's a dangerous notion that it is totally useless to reach out to someone who is contemplating suicide. Suicidal people are always torn between the desire to live and the desire to die. Therefore, if you suspect a loved one is considering taking his or her own life, be proactive in trying to get them help rather than letting them be. People take their lives out of the blue. Through your actions or words, most people who take their own lives really have communicated their intent before and to other people through their words, actions, and emotions. Therefore, it is very, very important to keep an eye out for the warning signs in the people around you. Someone who has their act together is not at all at a risk of suicide. On the outside, someone can appear to have it all, a great job, a healthy family, and an active social life. We look at their exterior and say, how could they even contemplate suicide? But you really don't know what's going on inside of someone. They could be in turmoil and we would not know it, since they are putting up a happy front. Thus, when you see someone exhibit even the minutest of warning signs, do not brush it off. Reach out to them instead.
Now you will ask me, what are these warning signs that I keep talking about? Well, a suicidal person will always display some kind of warning sign right before they go through with the decision of ending their lives. These warning signs could manifest in speech, mood, and behavior. If a person says stuff like, I don't want to live anymore, I have no reasons to live, I'm a burden to others, then that could be a warning sign in the form of speech. A person might also be excessively angry, or they might be very, very irritable and might lash out at you. Then that is a mood suicidal warning. If a person throws farewell parties, or they cut off themselves from society and friends, or they sleep a lot, or they might even sleep too little, they could even eat a lot or have a total loss of appetite, or they could get hooked on to some kind of drug or alcohol, then that is a sure shot sign of a behavioral suicidal warning. So you have to be aware of all these things happening around you, and you have to look out if these signs are in the people around you.
So how does one deal with a suicidal person? Number one, ask. Listen to them. Get them to open up about their feelings to you. Validate their thoughts and their feelings. And most importantly, tell them that you will be there for them and you will help them get through. Number two, get help. Contact a suicide helpline number and get in touch with a trained mental health professional. Number three, help keep them safe. Give them a sense of comfort. Remove all objects that they could use to harm themselves. And stay with them until they are evaluated by a mental health professional. Also inform someone they trust, like their family members or their parents.
Hello everyone, this is Siddhi Naik and I'm here to highlight some of the important legal rights which are guaranteed to mentally ill person. So, there is an act, that is the Mental Health Care Act 2017. This act aims at providing mental health care and services. This act promotes, fulfills, and protects the rights of such person while delivery of mental health care and services. So, let us see what are the exact legal rights which are guaranteed to such person. Under this right, every person is entitled to receive the best health care services. And this service is very affordable, so financial problem is not an issue. Under this right, every person who is below poverty line and even the homeless person can avail this service at free of cost. The mentally ill person cannot be secluded from society. And if the family has abandoned such person, then it is the duty of government to provide aid. Every person with mental illness has the right that the details with regard to their mental illness and treatment are protected under confidentiality. The person with mental illness can seek the legal aid to exercise the rights provided to them under this Act. They are also entitled to complain with respect to the deficiency of facilities provided to them. So these were the few important legal rights. While concluding, I want to say that you don't have to feel embarrassed to seek legal help, because mental illness is not.
Hello everyone, I am Divya Naik and speaking on Section 309 of Indian Penal Code. Section 309 of Indian Penal Code criminalizes the attempt to suicide as well as suicide assistant. Section 309 states that whenever attempt to commit suicide, the act towards the commission of such offense shall be punishable with simple imprisonment for a term of 1 year or with fine or both. Although Section 309 is still in effect, the Mental Health Care Act 2017 was enacted in 2018, has its restricted application. The provision of new Act states that under Section 309 of the IPC, any person who attempt to commit suicide shall be presumed, unless proved otherwise, to have severe stress and shall not to try.